Dead.
Are you alive?
Dead.
Ah, you're dead.
If I really were dead, I wish you'd care a little bit more.
Here.
Oof, that's cold.
Are you still going to run? Oh, that's 160, by the way.
No such thing as a free lunch.
I'm just kidding. Do you have a sec?
Huh?
You got this, boy.
Whoa!
All right, that's it.
Time to run just a little bit longer. That is the reason that I, Heihachi Hazama, ended up falling for her.
Kendall-san, I think the math teacher's gonna pick on me today. I don't know how to do this. Oh, this part, huh? I think you just need raw willpower. I didn't realize that you'd come back with some kind of spiritual theory.
Yuki Tendo, a junior in high school.
Tendo, you got 100 on the test this time, too. Keep it up!
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Yuki, yours! Whoa!
Whoa! She's got excellent athletic skills.
Tendo-san, you want to drink some delicious hydrogenated water?
And she's very popular.
Sorry, I got cram school today.
She's the perfect student who accomplishes everything she sets her mind to perfectly. That is Yuki Tendo. Tendo-san is looking as scrumptious as ever, isn't she?
What?
I was one of Tendo-san's classmates and one of the men that was interested in her. This is a story that happened last year. I was part of the track and field team, but one day I had an accident and had a pretty bad injury on my leg. I was told by my doctor that I would never run again, but I didn't care. I did my best to prove him wrong. I did my best and was able to get running again. My legs started to hurt pretty badly quickly, and I ran out of breath pretty quickly too, but I still continued to run. I just like to run. I love the sensation of the wind on my skin as I run through it and the feeling of leaving everything behind. I may not be able to run track and field anymore, but I wanted to continue running.
You got this, boy.
That's why I continued to run that day. When she cheered me on like that, it made me really happy. That was the reason that I fell for her. When we got placed into the same class after starting our junior year, I felt like it was just destiny that pulled us together. Also...
Hey, Heihachi?
I'm okay. The injuries aren't serious.
You fell straight down and hit the back of your head on the ground when you fell, so I think that's the problem here.
I like her so much, Tendo-san. Watching her behavior, it makes me feel like she might like me too. I don't know, actually, because I have no confidence at all, but I really hope and pray that I have a chance. I want to get to be her boyfriend no matter what happens, and once we start dating, we're going to do sexy stuff.
Hey, this guy's got a pervy look on his face. I'm sure he's probably dreaming of something really nice.
And so, after class... I really like Tendo-san.
Huh? Are you talking about me?
Oh, no. Yuki-san. Yuki Tendo-san.
Oh.
I was talking to a certain person about what to do with my crush. Her name was Eri Tendo. She was Yuki Tendo's older sister by 1 year. We used to be closer, as she is part of track and field, so she actually took good care of me, too.
What part of my younger sister do you even like, Hachi-kun?
Her face.
You answered that lightning fast, but it is such a shallow answer.
I also kind of like how kind she is, too.
Okay, so now I know that you're not looking at her personality at all.
I totally am, though. I said she was kind.
What part of her is kind, though?
Is she not like that when she's at home or something?
Who knows?
You know, you're her older sister, but you're not very much like her at all, are you?
Really? Are you trying to say that compared to my younger sister, I'm prettier than her?
Absolutely not. You are pretty, but...
More than my younger sister, right?
I actually try to avoid comparing things to other things when trying to set a value on something or someone.
Well, that's actually a really good idea to have.
So can you please tell me more about Yuki-san when she's back at home?
You are kind of grossing me out with how intensely you're coming at me.
Back on topic.
So, what did you want me to do? Well,
I just wanted to ask for your help.
Well, look at you getting straight to the point.
The advantage that I have over everyone else is pretty much that I know you, and honestly, I don't have any other connections to Yuki-san other than that.
I see.
Please, I'm begging you. I would really appreciate your cooperation with this.
Okay, sure.
Huh, that was easy. She agreed to help me out a lot easier than I had ever expected.
I mean, I've got no reason to turn you down, and this might actually be kind of fun.
Honestly, I'm pretty surprised, because Eri-san might have...
Wanna go out with the three of us then?
Yes, please! Maybe I was just misunderstanding or something. Whatever the case, if she says she's going to help, then I'm just going to accept her help. Which brings us to...
Hazuma-kun, your arms and legs are moving at the same time!
Eri-san planned a date with everyone, so I am currently out with the Tendo-san at the movie theaters right now!
I'm here too!
Today is really... well, thank you. Thank you so much!
You don't need to thank me. I didn't realize that you'd be this happy. You must have wanted to see that movie really badly, huh?
Yes, totally. That's definitely what it is.
What kind of movie is it?
It's a movie where a cat rolls over.
That doesn't sound fun. That sounds fun! Is my younger sister insane?
Why do you sacrifice yourself to that extent? Why don't you save yourself?
I'm sorry. This is the only way I know how to live my life.
Do you realize that your actions are going to cause many lives to be saved and many people will praise you for it? I can't do such a thing. I want you. I want you to find your happiness more than someone else's happiness.
Stop it! Stop it!
You can't stop me!
The two who were in love with each other were going through some kind of dramatic scene with each other's moral standings and professing love and other complicated things while a cat was rolling around. The heroine is actually being the final boss to protect the main character. I watched on and thought to myself, too much. Glance? Tendo-san really is just scrumptious. Huh? Eddie-san? Huh?
You have to be quiet while the movie's playing, okay?
What is she? No, wait.
Did you think that I gave up on you because I offered to help you without much hesitation or something?
Huh?
Sorry to break it to you, but I really haven't given up on you.
That's right. Eddie-san actually really likes me. She's always made that kind of appeal to me from before, so I always told myself that I personally like Yuki Tendo-san, not Eddie-san. After that, nothing really happened, so I figured that she had just given up on me, but...
You know, you really are too naive.
What? Stop!
Huh?
Crap! If I say something, then Tendo-san is going to notice because she's literally right next to me!
What's wrong, buddy? If...
Damn it! Why the hell isn't she found out? Is it because she's too quiet? It's because she's whispering, isn't it?
If you want me to stop, then how about you tell me you want me to quit very clearly, huh?
Please, stop!
Huh? What did you say?
Oh, you definitely hear what I'm saying.
You know, I still like you. I know you still like my younger sister and stuff, but it's not like you two are dating or anything. It should be fine if I mess with you just a little bit, right?
Huh? No, that's not okay at all, Eddie-san!
I mean, it's not like you're dating her either, so you don't really need to protect yourself and reserve yourself for her either, you know? So, you know, come on. Just listen to those instincts,
I like Tendo-san. I like Tendo-san. I like Tendo-san. Wait. They're both Tendo-san!
By the way...
Huh?
You can do whatever you want with me. Anything.
I like Yuki-san. I like Yuki-san! And that's how I kept repeating the name of my crush to myself in my head and made sure to resist Erdi-san's temptation, but...
Phew! That movie was so fun! I really loved the part where the cat was just rolling around!
Dead.
Looks like you're dead.
Well, if you really think I'm dead, can you be a little bit more concerned? I feel like Yuki-san said the same thing to me, too. I thought to myself, maybe they're just similar because they're siblings.
I'm gonna run to the restroom real quick. Yeah, take your time. You really put up a fight, don't you? Do you not have any urge or desire?
I'm actually a super healthy and super active high school boy, so I've got man urges and desires.
Your reaction was pretty weak for a healthy high school boy.
At some point, I reached a state of nothingness.
Sounds like you're ascending to a greater state of being.
I completely lack any sort of temptation that your average human holds.
I mean, I still have my chances.
Huh? We're still going to do more?
I mean, if you want to go out with my younger sister, you need my help for sure. Am I wrong?
I mean, sure, okay.
And I have no intention of giving up on you at all. So yeah, good luck, huh? Healthy high school boy.
I don't know if I can maintain my sanity. I've already had kids with you in my head, Eddie-san.
Jeez, how far have we gone?
Oh, I'm actually talking to your parents right now.
Things are moving as we speak, huh?
Ah, that was so close. I was about to propose to you.
You can totally do that. Wait, hang on just a second. This is literally just a shotgun marriage.
I think that if I marry you, it's going to be a shotgun wedding.
Why?
I mean, if you think about how things are going, don't you think so too? So I need to make sure that that doesn't happen. I have to maintain control.
Now, a shotgun marriage isn't ideal, or maybe that's just the way it goes, huh?
I feel like she's just not caring about anything at all anymore, just to get what she wants. And so...
Come on, get a little bit closer to me, hmm? We have to stick together, okay?
No, I really can't get closer than this. We were on the way to school. Maybe it was because it was raining. There were a lot of people on the train, pushing in, and the whole train was just full of people. I was unlucky enough to be where Eri-san found me. Which brings us to where we are now. And she doesn't care that we're surrounded by everyone. She continues to seduce me.
You're a tough cookie, huh?
If there were no people around, I probably would have pushed her over and taken her to a nice place where we could drink some delicious hydrogenated water to have a meal. Whew, that was close. Whoa!
Oh!
Sorry, are you okay? Wait, she's acting a little bit more passive than usual.
Yeah, I'm okay.
Huh? Wait a second, is she actually really good at being aggressive but not too good at defending herself? All right then, I guess I'm going to try to get back at her. No, that doesn't work, because I'm sure she's going to attack me with twice the force.
You know me well.
Huh? Did she just eavesdrop on my thoughts? This is bad. I need to wrap my head in aluminum foil. Rappity rap rap. Then, one day...
This is your room, huh, Yuki-chan? Don't...
Thank you for inviting us over today.
Mention it. Let's have our little study session, huh?
We had exams coming up, so a few of our classmates all decided to get together and have a study group.
If there's something you don't understand, don't hesitate to ask, okay?
And we were having the study group at Tendo-san's house. This is so intense. I detect Tendo-san's good scent. Oh, no, no, no. I cannot be thinking this right now because she's going to totally be put off by me.
You know, Yuki-chan's room smells really good. I wish I could pack it up in a little baggie and take it home.
Huh? I realize now that people can be genuinely stunned and shocked when they recognize someone that stands above them.
You want me to bring a bag?
And standing well above that person was Tendo-san. She was the one that stood above us all. Huh? Seriously, can I have a bag too?
Ew!
Huh? You're the one that asked for a bag to begin with.
I'm literally a girl.
I guess girls get away with saying anything to other girls.
Come on, let's stop joking around and study, huh?
Yeah.
Okay.
But thanks to that little goof session, I could feel myself be a little less on edge.
Huh? I wasn't joking around at all.
Huh?
I ended up using my crush's bathroom. I felt a little guilty about that. I wasn't sure if I was really allowed to use the bathroom. Don't think about it too much. Calm down, me.
Excuse me.
Welcome.
Huh? Click.
Huh? What? I let my guard down.
Well, now we're in a room isolated from the outside world with just us, Hachi-kun.
I had completely forgotten. This was Yuki Tendo-san's house, but at the same time it was Eri Tendo-san's house, which means that I was walking around with my guard completely down in enemy territory. Ah! That means that I need to expand my domain as well. Domain expansion.
Huh? What's gotten into you?
Invincible barrier!
Are you in elementary school?
If you do anything, then I'm going to pow you!
Oh, that thing that little boys do. I don't really get it, but...
Pow, 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 pow!
I think I'm going to become stupid.
Back on topic.
Ah, you let your guard down, huh?
If you don't move from there, I can't leave the bathroom.
I'm standing here because I have no intention of letting you leave.
Ah, she's completely got me.
All right, now let's begin.
Begin what? What are you planning on doing?
Are you okay? You're late to come back, so I decided to come by and check up on you.
What?
What? An angel? But this situation is horrible. If she finds out, she might think that I'm in some kind of weird relationship with her sister. This is not good.
Oh, well, well. Imagine if she found out about this.
I just need to get her away from the bathroom right now. I'm actually in the middle of dropping a fat log.
Huh?
It's actually in the middle of being dropped into the water right now.
Right. It sounds like you're busy. Well, good luck with that. I'm going to go back now, okay?
Did she leave? Whew, that was so close.
Huh?
What is that look on your face?
You do like Yuki, right?
Yes.
You realize she was definitely grossed out and put off by that?
Huh?
I mean, of course she was. You're literally talking about dropping fat logs at a person's house. That's not something you do at your crush's house.
Now that you put it that way, you're right. What am I doing?
You just noticed?
I may have won the battle, but I've lost the war, is probably an appropriate thought right now. Back on topic. Huh? Eri-san isn't paying attention right now. If there were any time to run away, it's now! Excuse me!
Huh?
I'm going to go back to the study group now. Bye!
Well, well.
That was close. That was close in a variety of ways.
You know, I know he's working hard, so I guess that makes sense why he's so strong. That was probably a little too aggressive on my part. And maybe the bathroom wasn't the right place. But man, why is he resisting me so much?
The next day...
Hey! Oh.
Duh. I ran right into Eri-san at school. There was no one around, which means it's just us. This is not good. I've got something super important to take care of.
Oh, come on, don't be so alarmed. I have something I want to talk to you about today. You do not look happy about that.
Well, I mean, you know. Huh?
That's so mean. I really just wanted to talk to you about something. You must hate me so much.
Huh? What? Okay, I'll listen. If it's just regular talking, then I'll listen.
Yay!
Huh? She was fake crying? So, what is it that you wanted to talk about?
Why do you resist me so much? But it's...
Well, it's because I like someone. I have a huge crush.
Isn't that a little strange?
Huh?
Well, I mean, you're not dating my younger sister, so it's not like you need to be some kind of Puritan and save yourself for her, you know? You could totally be in some kind of deviant-like relationship with me, but then date my younger sister later. And...
What is your definition of morals and sense virtue?
I don't know why, but it seems like you don't want my younger sister to find out that I'm coming on to you either. I think that if my younger sister were to find out about the fact that you're trying to reserve yourself for her or something when you're not even dating her, she might take it as you being too full of yourself.
But that doesn't mean that I'm going to be in that sort of relationship with you, Eri-san.
Why?
Think about it in the opposite sense. Would you just give yourself up to a man who is coming on to you? Someone other than me?
Absolutely not.
And therein lies your answer.
But you aren't really saying no, are you?
Huh?
I mean, if you really were, then you'd be saying no in front of my younger sister, too.
That's just because your younger sister will find out.
I told you this earlier, but that's just being full of yourself. Or what? Do you want to say that my younger sister has a thing for you or something?
That is kind of mean, isn't it?
In other words, I'm saying you're half-assed. What are you trying to accomplish here?
I like Tendo-san, so...
Huh? Me?
I like Yuki-san, so I'm rejecting you. That's it. Why do you care so much about me anyway?
What do you mean, why? Well, think...
I mean, there are all kinds of men in the world.
Think about it in my shoes. There are all kinds of women in the world. Why are you so obsessed with Yuki? It's better to be with the older girl who just keeps talking about how much she likes you over the girl who's far out of everyone's reach in your class, right?
I mean, because I like Yuki-san.
I'm the same way. I like you. You were injured and you couldn't run, but you continued to run and run, and I just fell for you when I saw you running without turning back. You just kept chasing your dreams. It was almost like I had some dreams too. Maybe it was kind of close to cheering and rooting for a really popular sports athlete or something. Just giving someone else your hopes and aspirations for achieving things, and then, before I knew it, I had fallen for you.
Eri-san was telling me how she felt without any kind of cushion. Eri-san?
I really like you.
Then I should actually face her without any cushions or brakes either. Honestly, I was pretty shaken up by how you were coming on to me. That's why I wasn't able to just tell you off and reject you very clearly. Just like you said, it's not like I'm dating Yuki-san, so I didn't need to save myself or anything. Sure, it would be pretty gross if you weren't even dating someone and they were like, I'm going to protect my virginity for you. I said no to you because I like Yuki-san. If I somehow succumbed to your seductions and we were in some kind of non-relationship relationship, then it wasn't because I liked you. That's why I couldn't fall for it. Because I will not fall for you.
Thank you, but I'm sorry. No matter how much you care for me, I'm not going to change. I'm going to continue seducing you.
But
I know. You don't see me as someone that you can actually love and date, but that's fine with me.
Huh?
Because I want to have sex with my crush.
Oh, it was a pretty primal human reason, huh?
You don't need to think that hard about it, you know? What?
I don't think I can be that relaxed about it, though.
Whatever the case, I understand what you're thinking now. Not that that means I'm going to let up at all. Besides, the reason that you said you can't fall for me right now is because you like Yuki, right? That means that if you ask her out and she completely shatters your hopes and dreams, then it might be my turn. Or are you going to continue loving Yuki for the rest of your life?
I mean, I would probably stop and try to find new romance at that point, but...
Then I guess I'll reserve that spot for if you get rejected, so... Don't forget about me, huh?
I know this for sure. If I didn't like Yuki-san right now, I would have fallen for her right now. Later, after hearing Eri-san's true feelings, I was walking in the hallways after class and...
What are you thinking, sis?
Huh? It's Yuki-san's voice. She's talking to someone in class? I looked inside from the hallway and... Huh?
What do you mean?
It's Eri-san.
Why are you getting closer to Hazumi-kun? I said stop it! He's mine!
What?
He's yours? Oh, come on, it's not like you two are dating. You can stake your claim on him yet. That is not the statement coming from everyone's favorite model student.
But he likes me too, right? If we both like each other, we're not that far off from dating.
You say that, but you're basically just leaving him hanging the whole time. If you really like him, how about you ask him out and go out with him, huh? That's... I'm sure it's that you aren't confident that he'll continue to like you after he sees the real you, right? Yeah, my younger sister definitely has a good facade that she puts up in school.
Shut up!
You're a good model student on the outside, but that's just a facade. It's not who you really are. The real you just has this rotten personality that threatens girls that mess with your crush, right?
You're the one with the rotten personality! You're messing with your own younger sister's crush!
I mean, I fell for him, too. What do you want me to do?
But that doesn't mean...
He's not anyone's thing, and you've got to move fast with these things. If you don't want him to be taken, then you should just show him who you really are sooner.
But if he doesn't like me...
Huh? Oh!
What? Good morning, Hazuma-kun! Is something wrong?
My younger sister is now broken.
Huh? Apparently the person that I liked had a second side to her. I didn't know how to take that and accept it, is what I thought to myself. Bonus!
Sis, what are you normally, like, talking about with Hazumi-kun?
What? Are you curious?
I mean...
Oh, you know, he's normally just talking about you all the time.
Really?
I mean, he likes you and I'm your older sister, so it would make sense naturally that he would come to talk to me about it.
You know, I'm so sorry, sis. I know that he likes me, you know?
You little shit.